Did you ever test a theory empirically? You can test the theory empirically if you have the methodology and if you have the data. Theories should be tested empirically to prove the validity of the theory. Although the theory is well established, the testing may not always produce a consistent result. So it may lead to some paradoxical result. So one such study was conducted on hexeroglycerin theory by Vasily Leontief in 1953. That study was turned out to be Leontief paradox. Welcome you all to the new video. So several studies were made on hexeroglycerin theory of international trade or modern theory of international trade or factor proportions theory of international trade. So Vasily Leontief made his study. That study came out to be a popular one, empirical testing of hexeroglycerin theory, and his study was popularly called the Leontief paradox, as his results were just the opposite of the argument of hexeroglycerin theory. So as per the hexeroglycerin theory of international trade, capital abundant nations export capital intensive commodities, labor abundant nations export labor intensive commodities. That means United States, as a capital abundant or capital rich nation, exports the capital intensive commodities like automobiles, aircraft parts. Similarly, US, as a capital rich or labor short nation, import labor intensive commodities like cotton, textile products. But when Leontief made a study on hexeroglycerin theory of international trade, he came out with a different story. His results were just the opposite of the arguments of hexeroglycerin theory, and it was the paradoxical results of hexeroglycerin theory. As per the study conducted by Vasily Leontief, he found that US, even though a capital abundant nation, import labor capital intensive commodity and export labor intensive commodity. This is the paradoxical and interesting result from the study of Vasily Leontief. So look at the methodology of Vasily Leontief, and this is how the study was conducted by Leontief, and he devised a new econometric model which is called input output analysis or input output model. This is econometric model to find out the capital labor requirements of export commodities and import commodities of the United States. And he collected the data for the period of 1947, but the study was conducted in 1953. The data were collected for the export import data for 1947, input requirements of export commodities and import commodities of the United States in 1947 were collected by Leontief. He collected the capital labor requirements for the production of export commodities of the United States in 1947. Similarly, he collected the capital labor requirements for the production of import substitutes rather than import commodities, as the import commodities of the United States is really happening outside the United States. So as the data on capital requirements of the production of import commodities were not available, so Vasily Leontief used the data of capital labor requirements of import substitutes in the United States. For example, rather than using the input requirements of the textile commodities in India, Leontief collected the input requirements of textile production in the United States itself. So this is the import substitute commodities, and he used capital labor ratio for imported commodities and capital labor ratio of exported commodities. So look at the empirical result of Leontief. Here you can see the capital labor requirements for the production of export commodities and import commodities of the United States in 1947. So look at the input requirements of the production of export commodities in the United States. This is shown in the second column of the table, where you can see United States employed 25,50,780 worth capital in the production of export commodities, and the United States employed 182 labor hours to produce total export commodities in the United States in 1947. So the capital labor ratio for export commodities was $14,015. So come to the input requirements for the production of import commodities. United States employed 30,91,339 worth capital in the production of import commodities, and employed 170 labor years for the production of import commodities in the United States. So the capital labor ratio of import commodities was 18,184. So capital labor ratio for the import commodities is quite higher than that of export. Input requirements or capital labor ratio of import commodities was 18,184. This is quite larger, quite higher than that of export, which is just $14,015. That means the capital labor ratio of import commodities divided by capital labor ratio of export commodities is greater than 1, that is 1.3. That means 18,184 divided by 14,015, this is 1.3. That means the capital labor ratio of import commodities was higher. But as per the Hatcher-Oakley theory, this should not be higher. The capital labor ratio of export commodities must be greater than that of import. But in the contrary, the capital labor ratio of import commodities was greater than that of export. That means United States imported more capital intensive commodities and exported comparatively labor intensive commodities. So this is the paradoxical result of the Hatcher-Oakley theory. This was found by Vasily Leontief in his study on United States trade data using input-output analysis in the year 1947. The study was actually conducted in 1953, depends on the 1947 trade data. It also means US import substitutes are more capital intensive than exports. In the light of Leontief paradox, a question will arise whether the HO theory need to be rejected. The simple answer is no. Why this is no? Why? Because Hatcher-Oakley theory is a well-established theory in international trade, and it is on the basis of the comparative advantage theory, which is still considered as the base of international trade, on which the trade will happen between two nations. The gainful trade will happen between two nations. So Hatcher and Oakley were in fact extending the comparative advantage theory into the framework of a factor proportions analysis. And moreover, this study, a Leontief study, was actually based on 1 year's data. He studied US trade data for the 1947 only. So that year may be an exceptional year. So that we cannot rule out the possibility of an exceptional year. So just 1 year's the result of a study based on just a 1 year data is in fact not able to rule out a theory, a well-established theory of trade. Moreover, Leontief in his study used input-output requirements for import substitutes in the United States rather than import commodities. He should have collected the input requirements of import commodities, as the capital labor ratio may not be the same in both nations. Finally, Leontief did not say comparative advantage is not the basis of international trade. So he did not actually rule out the possibility of comparative advantage, relevance of comparative advantage as a basis of international trade.